Good evening, everyone. This winter camp was all about leadership. Not necessarily how to be a leader now, but some skills and tips that can help them become leaders in the future. Things like listening, speaking, responsibility, and respect, and teamwork. They learned a lot about how to work as teams.
So our winter camp theme was The Leader in Me. Our students learned all the definitions, many definitions that it means to be a leader and leadership. And also we learned the 7 habits of happy kids. We adapted a play from this book and we put a lot of work into it, and our students worked really, really hard to put it all together tonight. So please sit back, relax, and we hope you enjoy the show. Thank you.
I don't feel like it. Maybe Sophie has a fun activity.
Sammy knocked on Sophie's door. Knock, knock, knock. There was no answer.
Sophie went to her library to get books.
And at least she's not bored.
So, Sammy went to Sophie's house. Pokey was lying in his hammock.
Hi, Pokey, what are you doing? I'm lying in my hammock. Can you think of something fun to do?
You can try lying in my hammock.
I thought that sounds even more boring.
I'm not even reading the other things.
So Sammy went to Lily's house. Lily was painting a picture.
Hi, Lily. I bought nails and a fancy for me to do.
Sure, you can help me paint a picture of myself.
I don't feel like painting. Can you think of something fun to do?
I think painting is fun, sorry.
Sammy thought, nobody seems to have any fun ideas. Maybe he could play with Angela and Ellie. So she went to her house. Alice Granny was painting from port.
Hi Granny, where is Ellie?
She's in bed.
Look, no one wants to have fun with me.
But Lisa, you drop two maps to for yourself.
What do you mean?
You need to find yourself. Just look around.
Sammy looked around. He saw trees, he saw clouds, he saw 3 garbage cans. One had an old radio on top, with wires sticking out. Sammy had an idea.
Granny, can I have that old radio?
Sure, but
Sammy took the radio home and put it on the floor of his room. When Ellie saw the radio, she broke into a huge smile like a slice of watermelon.
I love that robot.
Sammy said, Scoot was walking by Bruno's toy store when he saw a bird collecting kittens in the window. It was on sale for only $4.
Wow! I won't buy that, but I don't have $4. I need to plan out with a man.
Scoot went home and wrote out the list. Just then, Jumper came by.
What's that, Scoot?
It's a list of things I want to do.
And I'm sure I have a great idea. Let's sell lemonade. It's hot and people will want the cold drink.
That afternoon. They set up the lemonade stand. Sophie were the first to stop by.
Lemonade. I'll buy a cup. It's so hard to get.
Next, Lily stopped by.
Buy a cup for Ellie and two cups for me, and we are going to color.
After a few hours, Wood and Jumper have sold all their lemonade. They made $20.
Wow, $20! 10 for you and 10 for me.
I know just what I'm going to spend it on.
Jumper went to the toy store. He bought two candy bars, some bubble gum, popcorn, a cheap yo-yo with broke, and a small water gun. Hoop went home and read over his list. He saved some money, bought everything he needed, and still had $2 left.
I wish I could go too, but I spent all my money.
You should have planned ahead. I got everything on my list.
Otherwise, have fun at the movie.
Well, now you know what to do next time. I still have $2 each for us both to see movie. Come on, let's go.
Here are the words for your spelling test on Friday. Make sure you study a little bit each day so you get the words just right.
After school.
Hoki went home and took a nap. Just as he woke up, ding dong. It was Sammy.
Hiya, Pokey. Do you want to go for some new toys?
Sure. Pokey knew he should study, but going to find new toys sounded like more fun. Dessert. When they got there, Pokey saw an old drum.
Awesome, this makes a really cool sound. I'm going to play with it all day.
On Tuesday, Lily stopped by Pokey's house.
For my spelling test, but I guess I can do that later.
So So off to Lily's house he went. And when he returned home, he played on his drum until he fell asleep. The next day, Poppy went on a butterfly hunt in the pool, and later took a bite right from the jumper. When he got back, he suddenly remembered,
"Oh no, tomorrow is Friday. I haven't even looked for my spelling word. What should I do?"
Poppy tried to write them down, but there were just too many words to learn in just one night. The more Poppy tried to memorize them, the more confused he got. He finally gave up and went to bed. The next day at school,
what happened? Didn't you study? I know you can do better than this.
I wanted to study, but I can't find other things to do.
You should have to first things first then. Fun later.
He's right. You can do the test again next Friday, but this time don't wing it.
Downstairs and hand the note to her mom.
cantaloupe and strawberry into the house.
Wow, everything looks so good. Now I won't have to buy oranges and strawberries at the store anymore. And it's so healthy, what a treat.
Let's make a family of vegetable soup and strawberry shortcake. This strawberry is so juicy and very full of appeal to me.
I'm glad you're happy.
Act 5. Think first to understand. Then to be understood. One day, travel start by groups.
One apple with tea?
No, thanks. I choose that because I love my butterfly nuts.
But it's a sunny day, we can go play at Fish Island.
I don't feel like it.
Please, it will be so much fun. Let's go, let's go.
No, you keep talking and talking, you never listen. You go ahead and have fun without me.
Okay, talk to you later.
Jumper ran out. He jumped by tag along Ellie's house. She was sitting in her sandbox and crying.
Why are you crying? What's wrong? Without your back wet. Oh, you want to get wet. Okay, let's go swimming.
Wow, wow. It's like a back wet.
Oh, you want to go play in the woods?
No!
I give up. Maybe Lily will not have strength. Jumper picked up Ellie and took her to Lily's house.
Ding dong.
Hi, Jumper. Hi, Ellie. Lily, your friends are here.
We stepped her backwards.
Oh dear, your stomachs are backwards, your poisons.
Lily pulled off Ellie's water. Turn it round and put it back on her.
How do you figure that out?
You have to listen with your heart and your eyes, not just your ears. Didn't you see her stomachs on backwards?
Oh no, I didn't even notice. Man, I got hang of the soup. Wait for me.
They found Brooke sitting on a log in front of his house.
I can see you're really sad. What's wrong?
I already told you. I can't find my favorite red toy, my butterfly now.
Well, come on, let's look for it together.
I've been looking, but it's gone just lost forever.
Just then, Ellie tugged at Jumper's shirt.
Butterfly net by Wee-Wee's tree. Oh, I got it. The butterfly net is by Lily's tree.
So the three friends went by Lily's house. And spotted the butterfly net right next to Lily's tree.
My net! Now I remember I was chasing butterfly here yesterday. How did you figure that out?
You have to listen with your eyes and your heart, not just your ears.
Squash of my clothes. I'm leaving.
Where's the middle?
We can teach that butterflies for us.
Yeah, we can do it.
It took some work, but finally everyone agreed to play. But before they know it, the badgers have grown too much. Jumpers had to shoot.
Your heart and your soul.
use your body when you exercise. You use your heart when you play with your friend. And you use your soul when you like relax and do common things with friends.
The next day, Sophie was coloring with Lily, backtracking with Jumper, and listened to Poppy play her music. Well, she dug a butterfly, then she went home.
How was your day?
Balance. I used my heart to color. I use my body when I bike and my soul when I listen to music. Now I need to relax.
The next time,
by reading a book.
Thank you.